On their own, logs and traces may not be enough context to fully understand an issue. Today, we look at a feature for enriching telemetry with metadata for deeper analysis and security insights. Hello, and welcome to This Month in Datadog, where we'll update you on our latest features, product announcements, events, and more. This month, we're spotlighting the ability to enrich your existing Datadog telemetry with custom metadata using reference tables. We're also covering several new features of Datadog Observability Pipelines, a new security feature that's designed to identify and group together attacker behavior during distributed attacks, and auto-test retries, which helps to mitigate the impact of flaky tasks on your CI pipelines. But before we get to those, we want to let you know about a couple of blog posts we recently published. Over on the monitor, you can find a pair of posts about different aspects of the on-call experience. One post explores how to create an effective paging strategy and gets into topics like designing relevant pages and monitors and establishing on-call responsibility. The other is about how Datadog teams maintain an on-call practice that optimizes service reliability while preserving teams' velocity and well-being. Check out the video's description for links to these posts, or visit our website where you can find out about this content and more. And now, on with the show. Kicking things off is a trio of new Observability Pipelines features. First up is our new integration with SentinelOne. Endpoint detection and response systems record a lot of log data, which are not only expensive to store, but also difficult to get actionable insight from. With our new integration, you can use Observability Pipelines to collect and process security logs and then route them cost-effectively to SentinelOne. Second, our new integrations with Amazon S3, Amazon Data Firehose, and AWS Lambda. These products are common pathways for collecting logs from AWS services like CloudFront, whose logs can be noisy and difficult to process. Our new integrations enable you to use Observability Pipelines to simplify your collection, parsing, and routing so you get even more value from those logs. And rounding out our new Observability Pipelines features are keyword dictionaries, which are part of the Sensitive Data Scanner processor. Keyword dictionaries enable you to define terms that refine a scanner's detection rules when routing logs. That way, a scanner will only classify matches when there's a term within a defined range of characters. What this means is better accuracy and, more importantly, fewer false positives. There's a lot more to dig into. Learn more about these new Observability Pipelines features by checking out the links in this video's description. We're excited to announce attacker clustering, a new feature of Datadog's application security management. Today, distributed attacks are more challenging than ever to detect and respond to. Often attackers use coordinated strategies to blend in with normal traffic and avoid detection. Attacker clustering is designed to identify and group together attacker behaviors during these distributed attacks. When an attack is detected, this new feature automatically clusters attributes based on shared occurrences and creates a table with the cluster and key attributes of the attack. With these insights, security teams are better able to block specific attributes and stop attacks. Check out attacker clustering today in Datadog ASM. Rounding out our new features is auto-test retries. Now, you can automatically retry failing tests up to 5 times, which helps to mitigate the impact of flaky tests on your continuous integration pipelines. Not only does this help you avoid the need to manually rerun test jobs or even entire pipelines, but when a test fails across all retries, you can trust that the test is in fact actually broken. You can enable auto-test retries for your repository and test optimization settings. And that was just a sneak peek of the many features we released this month. For a full list, visit the link shown. This month, we're bringing you a 2-part spotlight. First, Jin will explore how to enrich your existing Datadog telemetry with custom metadata using reference tables. From there, Yash will dive into using reference tables to add more context to Cloud SIEM detections and investigations. Here's Jin.
Thanks, Jeremy. I'm Jin, the product manager for reference tables. As applications scale up and generate more telemetry, it becomes increasingly difficult to interpret IDs, error codes, or IP addresses ad hoc. With reference tables, which is now generally available, you can upload custom metadata to enrich your Datadog telemetry with your business critical context, like human readable names or threat intelligence, enabling faster real-time investigations and troubleshooting. Let's get started by uploading a reference table. There are a couple of ways to do this. One is setting up a cloud bucket or Datadog integration like ServiceNow to pull one time or synchronously. With a synchronous reference table, Datadog will automatically pull in the latest context from its source, ensuring your telemetry stays up to date in real time. But for our purposes, I'm going to upload a raw CSV. Here, I have a CSV table with a list of users and a score denoting how risky they are. I want to pull this table into Datadog. In a matter of minutes, my table is ready to be used with different Datadog products. There's a lot you can do with reference tables, including using tables with pipelines to automatically enrich telemetry at ingest time, joining telemetry with metadata at query time, and querying tables alongside other telemetry and advanced querying products. Reference tables empowers users to leverage business critical context automatically and ad hoc from a variety of sources. Now let's take a look at a specific use case. Here's Yash, who will take you the rest of the way.
Thanks, Jin. I'm Yash, the product lead for Datadog Cloud SIEM. Detection rules are essential for identifying potential threats. But when these rules are too broad, they can generate a lot of alerts. Cloud SIEM allows security teams to add context to their detection rules with Datadog reference tables. These tables enable teams to fine-tune rules with specific criteria, quickly filter out noise, and minimize false positives. Here's just one example. I'd like to write a detection rule that creates a security signal each time a failed Okta authorization log is generated from a user that is marked as risky in my environment. The table I need is already uploaded to Datadog. So on Cloud SIEM, I'm going to create a new rule and define my query. And adding my reference table is as simple as selecting the Add button and then Join with Reference Table. From here, we select our table, log field, and either the in or out operator. Since we want to include values from the specific table column, we're going to select in. Once our rule is created, through the reference table filter we added, we can see the additional context in a signal that the impacted user is risky in our environment. See for yourself how reference tables can add context to your detection rules by checking out Cloud SIEM today. And now back to Jeremy.
Thanks, Yash. Before we let you go, we have a couple of event-related items to share with you. In just a few short months, Dash will return to New York City. And this year, we've added a pre-conference day with exclusive workshops and partner events. You're not going to want to wait to get your ticket. Early bird pricing ends April 30th. Visit dashcon.io for more information and to register today. And finally, we recently wrapped up our latest Datadog Summit, which we hosted in London. Datadog Summits are our celebration of you, our customers and community. From the engineers whose feedback helps us to improve, to the developers who build integrations that broaden our ecosystem. Check out our blog and YouTube channels to see what we covered at past events, including London Summit. Or better yet, join us at our next event. And there's no shortage of events and webinars to choose from. Whether you'd like to join online or in person, there really is something for everyone. Discover what events we're hosting next by visiting the link in the video's description. And that wraps up today's episode. If you have a question, comment, or suggestion for a future episode, comment below or email us. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for future episodes of This Month in Datadog. See you next month.